So we're going to work on some vocal embodiment and hopefully in the process feel a little better in our bodies. So. Do, 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 do. Let's start with working with the part of us that we probably use the most during the day, unless we're sitting on our butts a lot due to COVID, doing work on our computers. Let's work on our feet. So crossing the foot over top of the leg, and see if you can get those shoulder blades down the back a little bit, which we will also work on tonight. Giving a little bit of knuckle love. That was the name of a band I was in. A little bit of knuckle love to the instep and outstep of the foot. Breathe while you're doing this. Still breathing. And then massage the heel. And then balls of the feet. And then see if you can get those fingers in between the toes. If you haven't done this for a while, it might be a little bit of a that we'd like that to be relatively easy. Might have to do it a few times. And then gentle circles with the toes. Then reverse the circle. And squeeze those toes as you seesaw the fingers out. Back to knuckles into the instep. Shoulder blades down the back. See if we can get that spine just a tad taller. And then a little bit into the ankle. And then whole foot with both hands. Freestyle, as the kids these days say. Do they say that? I think they do. And release and put the 2 feet together and feel the difference. Move the toes a little bit. It's hilarious. One is well greased and the other feels like clunk, clunk, clunk. So interesting. Like it feels in the one that I did like there's a million positions possible. The other one it feels like A, B. Feels like binary. Two spots. Interesting. All right. Second side. And knuckles into the instep. Shoulder blades down the back, middle outstep. And then massaging the heel. Breathing belly. And metatarsals or balls of the foot. Just under the toesies. Another technical term like metatarsals. And then seesaw yourself in between the toes. Holly, I can't see you, so I don't know if you can do both sides, but you can always massage the leg instead of the foot if you can't get to the second side. Quadriceps and hamstrings will appreciate it. Or you could get Steve to do the other foot. You're welcome, Steve. And seesaw the fingers out. Back to the metatarsals. Did I say metatarsals? No, back to the instep. So back to the middle of the foot. If you get that area, the whole foot tends to open up. So we do that twice. And now into that ankle, so between the ankle and the foot, that area we really want lots of space. And it tends to, of course, get squished down. And then whole foot, both hands, whatever, wherever you're led. A little bit of the top of the foot as well. Get back to that heel. A lot of feeling in the heel, but we walk so often we tend to lose the awareness down there. It's just a thing to touch the floor as opposed to part of our living selves. And bring it out and check out the two sides. Is it time to do the first side again? Anyway, just noticing that as you flex, that now it may be the way I feel it anyway. It doesn't feel binary anymore. An on and off switch. It now feels like there's movement between 0 and 1. Which is sort of a physical version of moment-to-moment awareness, I think. Feeling the journey of the toes, metaphor. All right. Let's continue up the body. Now that we've warmed up the feet, let's do our favorite. Sit on the toes. Shoulder blades down the back. I think we'll pull our little trick with the toes again. So let's bring the arms up, take hold of the right wrist, exhale over to the left, little sproutling palm tree, and then switch to the other side, and then switch to the other side. And once more, and then come off, keep with stretching out those toes. So let's do a ho right up into downward dog. Remember, the voice and breath have to happen just before the movement in order to engage the core and not your six pack. So like this. Ho. Does your voice feel connected to the rest of you? Bike ride. Drop the left armpit to the floor as much as you can. Then come up. Drop the right armpit towards the floor as much as you can. Tilt and tuck the tailbone. Head down. Look at the feet. Tilt and tuck the tailbone. Wiggle the tailbone. Can you draw an infinity symbol? Or a sideways eight. And then, ha, and upward dog, no interruption in voice. Ha, wiggle the shoulders. Ha, excellent. Let's come down onto our elbows. Hoe yourself into modified downward dog. Ho. And wiggle around. Drop one armpit to the floor, then drop the other armpit towards the floor. Back and forth. Opening, pressing through the elbows. And come down, and sitting, and a couple of rock and rolls. So this time we will do inhale down, exhale up. So like this, we inhale, use the ha to bring yourself up. Notice if it's easier. Inhale. This will help embody and help and make the voice healthier. Embody the voice, happier voice. Inhale. Connecting your voice to your core and to your support system. Inhale. Exhale. About three or four more on your own time. If you are not on a thick enough carpet, I totally get it. See, I'm on a true Persian rug here, so that helps. If you only did one, I totally get it. It's lovely if you can give yourself another. If you have enough carpet underneath you that it works. Because giving your whole spine a massage gives all your organs and muscles a massage. All right, back to all fours. Inhale. Down dog. And wiggle around and see if it feels any different post rock and rolls. Inhale, hey, your left foot forward. Hey, between the hands. Taking a look at your toes. Head down, back heel back, front heel down,
release the shins. Front toes free. Head hopefully coming straight out of the neck. Back through the back heel, down through the front knee, forward with the head. So you're lengthening the neck just as if we were in Tadasana. Yeah, good time to check out the nails. Back through the back heel, front knee forward, back heel back, neck forward, heel down, both heels down really, but it feels like heel back. Lift up the two hands, and back down. Lift up the two hands, back down. Inhale, hold yourself back to downward dog. And feeling the difference between the two groin muscles. Inhale, exhale, right foot forward. So as we transfer the voice, we're watching for if the voice is strong all the way through the movement. If it goes, hey, then that's pointing out that we're used to overusing our six-pack when we move and underusing our core. So by using the voice, we're engaging core, making the voice healthier all at the same time. Oh, and helping us breathe, too. Because if we're tightening our six-pack, we're holding our breath when we move, and that is never a good thing. Well, rarely. Back heel back, front head, as if you have two, forward, front heel down, back heel back, front knee forward, front toes soft. Taking a look at your nails, admiring the color of your pretty yoga mat. Breathe into your pelvic floor. Back heel back, front knee forward. This pose gets tiring as soon as we let go of that awareness of back and forward and start just letting it sink. Back through the back heel, forward through the front knee. Lift the hands up, or one of them. If you can, do a little jazz hands. Excellent, you get bonus marks for that. Lift the hands up again, jazz hands. Yes, I just made that up. Not a 400-year-old asana, that one. Jazz hands asana. Inhale. Oh, back to downward dog. And coming down onto our backs, hug your knees. If you clasped, if you interlaced the fingers, interlace them the weird way, the non-intuitive way. Lengthen the back of the neck, all the same rules apply. Shoulder blades down the back. Even though those arms are up and grasping the knees, we don't want the shoulders to be up. See what that did to my voice? Yeah, I want to keep those shoulders down.
one of my students at Grant Mac today was having, kept feeling tickling, and every time he sang, it didn't feel good in his throat. And I knew he was doing everything right because I could hear it. I said, you know what, go do a handstand. He did, he came back, solved. So what he had was upper body tension impinging upon his voice. So he just needed to do a handstand, get all the blood working up in his upper body, bing, voice fine. Well, that tells us a lot. No such thing as a voice problem. I repeat that about 4 times in my book. All right. Left leg flat, right leg up, clasp behind. Again, reverse the clasp from the intuitive one. Press through the heel. Leg tries to escape, hands resist. 40% of your power. Release, pull it in. Is it able to get a little closer? And again, escape, resist. I'm doing this more than usual these days because of the effects that sitting have on our hamstrings. And many of us, due to you know what, the thing that shall not be mentioned. That was a Harry Potter reference. We're doing a lot more sitting, most of us, many of us. And release. Pull in. Press through the heels of both feet. Easy to forget that other one. And go. Release. Pull in, again, 40%, and release, bring down, check out relative length of the legs, perhaps, other side, behind, link fingers the strange way, check out where your foot is on the ceiling, press through the heel, zoinks, escape the leg, hands resist, please breathing into the belly as you do this. Release, pull them in, go. Breathing below your belly button, jaw soft. Release, maybe pull in, really cool, kind of miraculous. And resist. Press through both heels. Yeah, I forget all the time and I just let that flat leg go limp on me. We want both awake. And release. In. Escape. Resist. Release. Last time. One, pull in. Two, press through the heels. Three, pull away. 3B, 3A, resist. And let go. Arms over the head, clasp the hands, lengthen through the armpits, palms facing toward the head, then slide the shoulder blades down the back without losing length in the arms. Once you've done that, stretch the arms out a little farther, and hang out. If your hands don't reach the floor, it's awesome to put a little block or a folded blanket underneath the hands so that it's not feeling like you're hammering on those acromion processes, which is that spot on the shoulder that dictates how far your arms can sweep up. Shoulder blades down, arms up and out. Shoulder blades down, arms up and out. Shoulder blades down the back, arms up. Inhale, exhale, release the fingers and gently little by little bringing those arms down and hands on the tummy. Feeling the temperature of the fire in your belly with your hands. knees into the chest. Changing across the fingers if you didn't go to the weird side already. Inhale, exhale, roll up. Sit on the toes. Clasp the hands behind the back. Squeeze the shoulder blades together. Lift the hands away from the tailbone. Squeeze again. Lift. Squeeze. Lift. Squeeze. Lift. Soften the jaw, soft gaze, be here. Any red flags in the shoulder joint? Cease and desist. You're very, very skinny and have loose joints. This is not one to do. Most of us, this is very good for us, especially these days. And release. And come off. Sit on the flats of the feet. Hug. And let's grab our 5-inch red sunball. Ooh, look, it goes with my outfit. It's like I plan these things. Right on that belly button. And a gentle, as gentle as this could possibly be, rolling it around in the belly. Get to the sides a little bit more than you might think. So, as far to each side as you can get. The shirt might interfere, but you'll figure it out. Right up into that solar plexus area. And then come out. Grab the two blue. If you don't have the two blue handy, you can use a pillow. And right at the top of the chest. Right here. Obviously, if these two blue are not big enough for you, then you can use a bolster or a pillow. Those of us that this does work for, right on the upper lung lobes. Arms back, head down. Just let your full body weight drop into those balls. and breathe into them. Turn your head to the other side. Give yourself a ha, see what you notice. And then yellow sun ball, 6-inch. Again, yoga bolster, folded rolled blanket. Also possible, but right between the shoulder blades. And if your neck is okay with it, can be without a pillow. But if your neck doesn't like it, definitely put a pillow behind so that your chin and forehead are relatively even. Bring the arms up and down the back and then up again, down beside the hips, up past the head. Down and just keep going. A little interpretive dance here. If you have an instinct to move that ball or move your body slightly higher or lower, get another spot up there below the neck but above the bra strap. Spot that's hard to get at when we're doing some sitting, or becomes hard to get at. Continuing with your interpretive dance. I'm a flower. Then bring your hands up and then go to the side, back and forth. Down beside the hips, roll off the ball, move the ball enough that you can lie flat again, and feel what you feel. How's How's that back feel against the floor now? Is any different? So now that we've done that, let's test it out. Feet flat. Comfortably close to the bum, about an inch between the two knees, a couple of inches, an inch and a half between the 2 feet, arms by your sides, hoe yourself up, so the hips up, and then clasp the hands behind the back, roll the shoulder blades together, little bridge, I think you all know the deal. The key though is, send your voice through your feet. Oh, this pose should feel like a down motion. We'd like it to feel like a down motion as opposed to an up motion. Clasp hands, squeeze the shoulder blades together like we did when we were kneeling. Lengthen the neck, press through the heels, let go of the butts, and breathe. Looking for repose in the pose. Pressing through the heels, let the butt muscles go. The butt muscles, that was another name of a band I was in. I was in a lot of bands. And release the hands and down. Luckily, I'm used to hearing no laughter when I tell my jokes. So this is completely normal. I'm going to keep at it here. Again, you're welcome. Lucky, I think I'm funny. Inhale, hoe through the feet. Oh, feels like the hips launch. Clasp the hands, roll them, squeeze them. Feet down, butt relaxed, groins up, butt relaxed. The heels keep the butt in the air, not the butt. Breathe low, well, which is now high. Breathe into your pelvic floor. And release. Moment to moment awareness. Noticing the moments. Hug your knees into your chest. Inhale, exhale over to the right. And come to standing. Front of your mat. Actually, I'll go this side. Front of your mat. Using a ha to bring your left leg lengthwise, legs length, heading into warrior one. So the feet will be parallel. Inhale. Ah. Inhale. sides down the back, arms up, just like we were practicing before. Shoulder blades down the back, arms up. Shoulder blades down the back, arms up. Back of the body down, front of the body up. Except for the neck. Think the neck up, lengthening, rest of the back body down, heels down, toes soft, especially the front toes. Front knee a little bit towards the middle, odds are, unless you're used to doing this and it's already there. Inhale, gather strength, ha yourself forward. Ha! The voice engages the core. Reset. Right leg this time. And see if you can float it just a little higher than you otherwise would and get a little bit extra length. Inhale. Inhale up. Both heels down, front knee aiming towards the midline of the foot, shoulder blades down, neck up, front body up, shoulder blades down, front body up, hands awake, palms facing each other for magical effects, inhale, exhale out. Come to center, a little bit of a shake. Let the shoulders bounce. Let the jaw bounce. Keep that voice going. Shoulders bounce, jaw bounces, head bounces. Shake it a bit harder. Stand in Tadasana and notice posture, energy, strength, stability. Grounding. And ease of standing. Shavasana. gently wiggling your fingers and toes. Rotating wrists and ankles. Rolling over to the right hand side and hugging your knees to your chest. Inhale, exhale yourself up to sitting, eyes still closed. Still inside. Namaste. Thank you all.